Welcome, my dear students, for online class from Manikeshwar Relil Model High School. Dear students, now I am going to discuss on English second paper for the SSC students. Today's topic: changing sentence. Borishal Board, 2016. Going to next step. Question A. Bangladesh is a low-lying country. Interrogative. Bangladesh is a low-lying country. Interrogative. Dear students, you have to change into interrogative. So, question, my dear students, is there any auxiliary verb in this sentence? Yes, my dear students, there is the auxiliary verb in this sentence. This auxiliary verb is. This is auxiliary verb. So, my dear students, while changing into interrogative, you know, auxiliary verb, you have to bring auxiliary verb before subject. You have to bring auxiliary verb before subject. As subject, Bangladesh. So you have to set, firstly you have to write is. And if the sentence is affirmative, you have to change into negative. If the sentence is negative, you have to change into affirmative. So my dear students, first you have to write is. ANS answer. First you have to write IS. And you have to write, you have to add NT, N apostrophe T with this verb, because this sentence is positive or affirmative. You have to write subject. Here subject Bangladesh. B A N G L A D E D E S H Bangladesh. And then you have to write next part of this sentence. Next part. A low-lying country. Next part. A low-lying country. You have to write next part. A low lying, L O W L Y I N G, low lying, C O U N T R Y, country. And you have to write question marks. Isn't Bangladesh a low lying country? So my dear students, answer, isn't Bangladesh a low-lying country? Question B. Every year, natural disasters visit us. Every year, natural disasters visit us. Passive. Dear students, you have to change into passive. So my dear students, question, is there any auxiliary verb in this sentence? Is there any auxiliary verb in this sentence? No, my dear students, there is no auxiliary verb in this sentence. So if you do not find any auxiliary verb in a sentence, you have to search, you have to find. B1 applies B1 plus S or ES applies B2. So my dear students, notice carefully as this is object in this sentence. We know principal verb is used before object. So visit principal verb. Subject is used before principal verb. So natural disasters subject. So natural disasters subject. So my dear students, why changing into passive, you have to write. Firstly, you have to write subject of object. Here subject as here subject object as subject we. You have to write we. ANS. You have to write we, WEE, and then you have to write auxiliary verb. But there is no auxiliary verb. In this sentence, but there is no auxiliary verb in this sentence. So my dear students, if you do not find any auxiliary verb in a sentence while changing into passive, you have to go to next step. You have to bring or set extra word. If you find B1 in a sentence, you have to bring am is are. You have to bring extra word am is are. The students, here visit, this is verb. Here visit, this is verb, and this verb is B1. So you have to set am is are, extra word. You have to set extra word am is are. Here subject we, so you have to set R. A R R, and then you have to set B3 of B1. You have to set B3 in instead of B1. Here B3 visit. B1, this visit, visited. B-I-S-I-T-E-D, visited. And then you have to write by. B-Y, by. You have to set object. You have to set object of subject. As subject. Natural disasters. NATURAL, natural. DISASTERS. You have to write every year. EVERY, every YEAR. we are visited by natural disasters every year. This sentence has been changed into passive. You can change into passive by using this formula. Question C. Flood is one of the most dangerous, one of the most, the student, this is type mistake, one of the, you have to write one of the most dangerous natural disasters, comparative. You have to change into comparative. Why changing into comparative? If you find one of the plus adjective three, if you find one of the plus adjective three, why changing into comparative? Firstly, you have to write subject and verb. Flood is. This is subject, flood, and verb is. Subject, flood, verb is. Firstly, you have to write subject and verb. F A N S F L W D flood I S S, and then you have to cut one of the plus, you have to cut one of the, one of the, you have to write adjective two, you have to write adjective two of adjective three instead of adjective three. Here adjective three, most dangerous. You have to cut most and you have to write more. More, most. More adjective two, most adjective three. So you have to write most, more. M-O-R-E, more. And then you have to write dangerous, D-A-N-G-E-R-O-U-S, dangerous, and then you have to write then most other, you have to write then, T-A-N, then, T-A-S-A-N, then, M-O-S, M-O-S-T, most, O-T-A-C-R, then most other. You have to write then most other, and then you have to write next part of this sentence. Next part, natural disasters. Natural disasters. N A T U R A, natural, D I S A S T E R S, natural disasters. Flood is more dangerous than most other natural disasters. Going to next step. Question क्वेश्चन डी, इट इज ढाका सिटी व्हिच हैज नॉट येट suffered any severe earthquake. Simple. It is Dhaka city which has not yet suffered any severe earthquake. Simple. Question, my dear students. Is the sentence complex or compound? You have to identify, is the sentence complex or compound? So there is a truth in this sentence. It is dot dot quiz. It is subject. It is plus subject plus quiz. If you find this structure, it is plus subject plus quiz. While changing into simple, you have to cut it is, and you have to cut quiz. You have to cut it is, and you have to write Dhaka city, and then you have to cut quiz. You have to write next part of this sentence. Next part, has not yet suffered any severe earthquake. ANS answer. The students, firstly you have to cut it is, and then you have to write subject Dhaka. DHAK Dhaka, CITY Dhaka city. You have to cut quiz. WHICS. You have to cut quiz. You have to write next part of this sentence. Has not not yet yet suffered suffered anyspere suffer earthquake. Dear students, Dhaka city, you have to cut it is and quiz. You have to write next part of the sentence. Dhaka city has not yet suffered any severe earthquake. Simple. E, people living in the island can escape flood. Complex. You have to change into complex. So my dear students, firstly, you have to identify who is principal clause, who is subordinate clause. So, my dear students, people living in the highland. This is subordinate clause, and people can escape flood. Can people can escape flood. This is principal clause. So my dear students, notice there is a tools or format in this sentence living. So question: is the sentence simple or compound? So one subject, one predicate verb, simple sentence. So one subject, people, one predicate verb, can escape. So this is simple sentence. In the simple sentence, if you find b1 plus ing, if you find b1 plus ing, why is changing into complex? You have to come who. You have to come who. Who is that? Here, people, personal subject, personal pronoun, personal subject. So you have to set who. The students, first you have to write people, people. First you have to write people, and then you have to write who, because people personal subject, HOW, who, and then you have to set B1. Dear students, notice carefully. Principal clause indicates future conditional. So you have to set B1, and you have to cut ing. You have to set live, live, live. And then you have to write next part of this sentence. Next part: in the highland can escape flood. In the HIGH, LAND, land, CAN, can, ESCAP, can escape, FLOOD, flood. ANS answer. Question F: crops are damaged by this flood. The students, you have to change into active. Why changing into active? Firstly, you have to write subject of object after by, to, at, with. After by, to, at, with. So firstly, you have to cut by, and then you have to write this flood. This flood. ANS THIS this FLOOD flood. This flood. You have to cut by and you have to write this flood. And you have to set auxiliary verb, but there is no auxiliary in this sentence. So my dear students, question, you can say, sir, there is auxiliary in this sentence. This auxiliary are, but this is extra word. My dear students, there is no auxiliary verb in this sentence. According to the rules of Poisson's, this is extra word. You have to cut extra word. If you cut abuser, you have to set D1 of B3. You have to set D1 of B3. So damaged. You have to damage. You have to write this flood damage. You have to write this subject, this flood. This is singular subject. So you have to set S or ES in this verb with the verbs. D-A-M-A-G-E-S, damages. This flood damages. And then you have to write subject. You have to write object of subject. Here subject props. Here subject props. C-R-O-P-S. This is object. You have to write object of subject. Crops. This flood damages crops. So my dear students, notice carefully. You have to cut extra word. Here extra word are. You have to cut preposition by to add with. Here preposition by. This you have to cut. You must cut. This verb and by. So my dear students, I hope that you have understood better going to next step. Question G, who does not know the consequence of the tsunami? Who does not know the consequence of tsunami? Assertive, you have to change into assertive. So my dear students, if you find this structure, who plus negative, while changing into assertive, you have to set everybody. You have to set everybody in a set of who. You have to set, first you have to set everybody in a set of who. And then you have to write S or ES with the principal verbs. Here, verb no, you have to write knows, K-N-O-W-S, knows. A-N-S. First you have to write every, E-V-E-R-Y, every, B-O-D-Y, everybody. And then you have to cut who does not. If you card does not, if you cancel does not, you have to set S or yes with the principal verb. Here principal verb knows. No, you have to set knows. K-N-O-W-S. K-N-O-W-S, knows. And then you have to write next part of this sentence. The CO and con A-C-Q-U-E-N-C, consequence of tsunami. T-S-U-N-A-M-I, tsunami. You have to set full stop. Everybody knows the consequence of tsunami. Going to next step. Question is, the recent flood was very devastating. The recent flood was very devastating. Exclamatory. The recent flood was very devastating. Exclamatory. You have to change into exclamatory. So my dear students, if you find very great really in a sentence, while changing into exclamatory, you have to come how or what. First you have to write how or what plus a oblation. So my dear students, notice any article A, if A is used before very, if A is used before very, you have to write how, but no article before very, you have to set A plus very. You have to find A plus very. You have to write what plus A plus N. But no article before very. You have to set how. A is O W, how. Firstly, you have to write how. H-O-W, instead of very. You have to write how instead of very. And then you have to write next part of this sentence before very. After very, you have to write next part of this sentence after very. Next part, devastating. D-E-B-A-S-T-A-T-I-N-G, devastating. How devastating. And you have to write subject and verb. Here subject, the recent flood was, you have to write. T-A-C, the R-E-C-E-N-T, recent. F-L-W-D, flood, W-A-S. You have to set exclamation marks. How devastating the recent flood was. Again, listen. If you find very great really in a sentence, so changing into exclamatory, you have to come. So that you have to come how or what plus A plus N. If you find A plus very, you have to set part plus a of less n. If you find only vary, you have to set how. So my dear students, in this way, by using this formula, firstly I have written how, and then you have to write next part of this sentence after vary. So next part devastating, I have written this word devastating, and then you have to write subject and verb. Here subject and verb, the recent flood was. Subject, the recent flood, verb was. I have written this, subject and verb, and I have set exclamation marks at the end of this sentence. Question I, Bangladesh is in the active earthquake zone. Bangladesh is in the active earthquake zone. Negative. The students, you have to change into negative. Question, is there any auxiliary verb in this sentence? Yes, my dear students, there is auxiliary verb. Is. This is auxiliary verb. So this is subject. Subject plus auxiliary. If you find the structure, subject plus auxiliary verb, while changing into negative, you have to write subject plus auxiliary verb plus not. First, you have to write subject plus auxiliary verb plus not, and then you have to write. You have to change into keyword of and you have to set antonyms of keyword. You have to set antonyms of keyword in this sentence. Keyword active. In this sentence, keyword active. Antonyms inactive. So firstly, you have to write. Subject is subject Bangladesh. First you have to write Bangladesh is not. ANS BANGLADES Bangladesh is NOT not. You have to set not, negative word not, after auxiliary verb. If you find this structure in a sentence, you have to write in the, and this is keyword active. You have to set inactive. INACTIV inactive. EARTHQUAKE earthquake. ZONE then. The students, Bangladesh is not in the inactive earthquake zone. By using this formula, you can change into negative from affirmative. Question J, Dhaka is the most risky city in the earthquake. Positive. Dhaka is the most risky city in the earthquake. Positive. Dear students, question, Is the sentence superlative or comparative? Firstly, you have to identify the sentence is which is comparative, which is superlative. Is the sentence is comparative or superlative? You have to identify is the sentence superlative or comparative. So my dear students, you have to change it to positive. D plus adjective 3 in this sentence. There is a tool. D plus adjective 3. D plus adjective 3. If you find the structure, why changing it to positive? You have to come. No other dot dot s plus adjective 1 plus s. You have to come. No other dot dot s plus adjective 1 plus s. So firstly, you have to write no other. A N S answer. N O T A C R. No other. And then you have to write city in the earthquake after adjective 3. City in the earthquake. You have to write next part of this sentence after adjective 3. City in the earthquake. Earthquake. Dear students, you should remember that singular subject and singular verb are used after no other. You should remember then that. You should remember that singular subject, singular verb are used. Singular subject and singular verb are used after no other. So you have to set singular verb. Notice carefully in this sentence, there is a verb is in this group, singular verb is. So you have to set is, is, is. And then you have to set s, ass. You have to write adjective 1 of adjective 3. Risky, most risky, more risky, 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 more risky, most risky. So you have to set risky, ass, you have to set s, and then you have to write subject, Dhaka, Dhaka, Dhaka. No other city in the earthquake is as risky as Dhaka. So my dear students, I have discussed new way, new system. So I hope that you have understood better and better. I will try to present any grammatical part easily. So you should follow, you should visit my channel regularly. So my dear students, you know a tree is known by its fruit. So you should follow this proverb. Practice makes a man perfect. You should follow this another proverb. So Have a good day. See you next time. I will be for with a new video. If you are benefited from my lecture, from my teaching, you must subscribe my channel. If you benefited from my teaching, you must subscribe my channel. Thank you very much. Up to the next video.